watch the full video. Hey guys, welcome to this video. In this video, I will show you how to reach Mythic real quick with complete domination feat Liomord. Liomord is one of the most underrated hyper. But if you use him properly, he can be real disaster, especially in lower leagues like Epic and Legend. He is one of those heroes who can solo carry his whole team. After hitting level 4, he can start his real fight, but before that, don't engage. Over here, Bane is extending a little bit. Let's take advantage of that. Just like that, you can easily pick off any hero. After getting one or two items, he can literally go for a 1v3 fight. Over here, I'm securing the turtle and Aulus is overextending a little bit in top lane. Aldous is engaging on Aulus with his ult. I need to secure the turtle quickly. Plus, Aulus is low in HP. Okay, that's a fair trade. 2-for-1. Now I need to rotate to other lanes. Liomord's skill set is really good to one-shot any squishy hero. If you manage to do this combo, you can easily one-shot any squishy hero. One more important tip about Liomord is that only play aggressive when you got your ult ready. When you don't have your ult, try not to engage or poke your enemies with your first skill. When you got your ult, you can go as much aggressive as you want. But don't overextend. Or you will die like this. By the way, I did this on purpose to show you guys. We are on a gold lead. So as soon as I notice a team fight is forming in top lane, Liomord is good hero for snowballing. Once you are on lead, you can easily keep boosting that. Now let's take a look at his build. For perfect snowballing, this build is really good. Yeah, you saw it right. I use sleeping time in Leomard. Leomard's main damage is in his ult state.
You have slain an enemy.
So whenever I play Leomard, I totally focus on CD build. That means fleeting time. Now, what's the use of fleeting time over here? During your ult state, if you manage to get kills or some assist, then
your team destroyed and you have slain an enemy.
It will drastically reduce his ult CD, which will help you to continue team fight. If you manage to secure more than 2 kills in his ult state, then there will be 0 CD on his ult. If you get 0 CD in his ult, then you will manage to continue team fight for a longer time. Now, let's talk about his weaknesses. Leomard's damage will shine from early to mid game. After that, his damage will start fading.
Your team destroyed the turret. The enemy has been slain. Kill.
So always try to end your game quickly. Maximum 13 to 14 minutes. Don't extend more than that. Second, always try to ignore high CC heroes. Always dive in for the back lane squishy ones. Plus, try to start team fight with your ult. Plus, if you got fleeting time and manage to secure kills, then your ult will get CD like this. No CD at all. So what is your opinion about sleeping time build on Leomard? Isn't it OP? Plus, if you got Angela in your team, then try to buy sleeping time in both of them. They will easily dominate the whole team fight. All on their own. Leomard with Angela equal to 1 versus 5. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching.
Yeah.